They don't know Emmanuel loving. That's a problem for a lot of people. It's how funny how y'all can look at this Bible and see the names is here, see the content is here, and just keep rushing stuff off. Y'all all need, look, you know what? Thank God we all gotta meet the Maker, right? And we all gotta be held accountable for our own actions here in the world. But you remember, deception is the greatest sin in the eyes of God. Doubt and unbelief is not a sin, but it's the greatest thing that besets you from God, okay? Well, doubt and unbelief, it just calls you to live a sinful life. It's not a sin, but if you walk in doubt and unbelief, you're not a believer. You're not in the covenant. So you're living a sinful life. It's okay. There's always repentance. We read it in Acts chapter 5. So you can go ahead and read it to some. But let me just go through this. When you're trying to build your life with Jesus, the name Jesus does not mean God is with us. God with us. It just doesn't, okay? There's some real teaching going on right now. I think when we start at the basis and just get people names right, make the introduction all over again, God, what would you have me do? He'll tell you, first of all, call me by my name. He said, because he said in the Bible, my people who are called by his name, what's his name, y'all? It sure ain't Jesus. And then Emmanuel is God with us. So Emmanuel ain't even God. He is God with us. Just still God. Until we get back to God, and yes, God, we got to do some things with Christ in between and all this other stuff, but God, Yahweh, God, Yah, Elohim, El Shaddai, God. Almighty One, Mighty God, God, we need to get back to the basics. We need to get back to what's truly right. So with that being said, y'all, if you're trying to build your life with this word right here, with Jesus, it's not God with us. But now, if you go ahead and you get with this right here, Emmanuel, God with us, and there you have it, folks. That's the story. That's the difference of their names. He is Emmanuel. Jesus is some name stuck on you Christians to worship that's so far away from your truth. And that's just thus saith the Lord. You're still disobedient, you're still disobeying, you're still following after other gods. Again, whoremongering, fornicating, being disobedient unto God. And I would start there. I would just start there. You know you shouldn't eat pork. I would just start there. Look at the Jews over there. The Jews took everything you're supposed to be doing. That's why they so blessed. That's why they walking in the covenant with God. Because they following his ordinances, his commandments. A lot of them don't follow Christ in the Christian ways. A lot of them just don't. And if they do accept Christ, because a lot of them, remember, didn't accept Christ. But if they do accept Christ, they still don't take a lot of the Christianity that's with it. Because these people know that Christianity was never a part of your culture, so they did everything they can to manipulate, deceive, and confuse you with Christianity, coupling it on top of Christ with Jesus, when really his name is Emmanuel, and it means God with us. And Christians, we should not forget that. We say these words and we throw them out here, but the truth be told, it's a cover-up. They use it around Christmas time, but not, why not use it all the time? That's his name. So with that being said, God bless you. His name is Emmanuel. It's not Jesus. And you have the proof right here for yourself. It's all right here. I enjoyed the teaching today. Thank you so much for hanging out with me. God bless you all. And remember, there's a couple key things that this guy right here did that sets you apart from your Jesus. Okay? See, Jesus got y'all worshiping him. But this guy Emmanuel right here, this guy Emmanuel, he looked up to heaven and gave thanks. He broke the bread and it was enough food to perform a miracle to feed 5,000. Plus wife and kids. This guy right here, Emmanuel, he went to the Garden of Gethsemane and he got down on his knees. He looked up to heaven, I do believe, because I don't think Christ looked down, because he know hell is down there. He know Satan lived down there. But he know his Father in heaven is above. So I believe he looked up, even though he was sweating blood and brow, sweat from his brow, blood and sweat popping out of his forehead. I think he looked up and prayed. Well, did he look up to himself? Did he pray to himself? When he went to heaven, is he seated on the right hand of himself? That's what church do for you. That's what your pastors, preachers, and teachers is feeding you. It's all up and down. Honey, let me tell you something. The Bible says you are an ambassador for Christ and you're a soldier for Christ. And the way you be a soldier for Christ is you contend the truth, you contend the faith. You don't use the word of God to fight other people, okay? No, you use this word to contend the faith like I'm doing. Because Satan don't like this, people, Christians, y'all don't like this. I'm contending the faith though. I'm confident in what I know I'm doing. And what thus saith the Lord is asking me to do. And what thus saith the Lord is asking me to say. You don't see me typing out no Bible scriptures and just bluntly. You know, there's a lot of you emotional Christians out there too. Emotional Christians out there. When this word of God is supposed to sustain, I get teary-eyed and passionate when I'm about to say something. I feel like, man, why are you messing with God's people? Why God's people don't get it? Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Come on. Come, 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 come on. Come on. Okay. So, Emmanuel, another thing he said, he always said, I'm sent by someone. I'm sent by my Father. Jesus don't do that. Jesus says, I'm the Father. At least that's what Christianity is telling you Jesus is saying. But if they read the Bible, even the saints that Jesus is here, copycat Yeshua, said, I was sent by my Father. I came to do the will of my Father. And y'all keep putting it off on Jesus like he is the Father. With the name Emmanuel, God is with us. That's what the name means. God with us. Jesus don't mean God with us. Jesus, the name Jesus means, is a Greek word originating from the Greek after the Latin. It's used in the English, but it's a rendition of a Hebrew name, Yeshua. Damn, they try to confuse you, don't they? Thank God I don't like confusion, because confusion is the devil is the author of confusion. And whoever did this to the Bible, whoever got you as a Christian confused out there, whoever confused the world and the masses, is the Bible calling the children of wrath, the children of disobedience, the son of perdition, okay? That's who did this. Satan, son of perdition. Devil, son of perdition. Anybody that had their hands on this book here, know they did. They know they have to answer to God for it. But we can take our time to rightly divide the word of God, and we also can break it down line by line, precept by precept. His name is not Jesus. His name is Emmanuel. And it means God with us. Jesus does not mean God with us, okay? Thank you so much, Facebook. God bless you. I hope this helps you because, again, like I said, I'm being set free. I see a whole lot of things going on in this world, and I'm just really trying to make a difference. I believe I have made a difference. And that's all God really asked me to do, just fall back. And you feel like the Bible says you're going to preach the word of God. It says with envy, with strife, and with love. You choose. You know why it says? Because nonetheless, Christ is being preached. Nonetheless. But I think people will receive it a little bit better if it's being preached, when people can receive it. Care if you do it, hate, love, envy, strife, it don't matter. Just do it in a way where people can receive the truth. That's all I care about right now. You keep the Christianity, and like I said, I'm far from not being a believer. I'm more of a believer now than I ever been in my life. And all you gotta do is just start believing what God said in the Bible about you. And not what you've been taught. And not what you think you know. Because, honey, let me tell you, all these years of your preaching, I could debunk you. I could debunk everything that you out here telling these people is right. And you know it's wrong. But I'm not here to bring you down. I'm here to lift you up too. Say, hey. Do you know it say this in the Bible right here? Hey, do you know you out here posting this right here? That's why I just laugh at you people. You try to get everybody in your groups and stuff like that. You lock us in. Honey, let me tell you something. You better lock and load in this word of God. Stop trying to deceive people with that nonsense. And you getting them too. Y'all just out there left and right, running behind these people, hooping and hollering, and ain't feeding you. And you wonder why every Sunday, every day, you going around that same wilderness, that same mountain. I did it. So, you keep going around that same mountain, but like I said, I don't know about you guys, but I know his name is Emmanuel, God with us. I know his name is Yeshua. It's up to you to believe. Let your faith decide. Do your homework, study. Don't just go agree. Even with the regular traditional Christian stuff, say, hey, wait a minute. It says this here. It says that there. Can I go home and check it out? Happy I don't even bring your Bibles to church anymore because you rely on overhead or your tablets and stuff like that. Let me tell you something. It's up to you to work out your salvation. If you don't want to be a Christian believer, that's up to you. I'm not telling nobody not to be a Christian. I'm not telling nobody not to be a believer. I would say be more of a believer. Follow the way. Follow God's way. Follow Yahweh. All makes sense, right? But good night, Facebook. God bless you and thank you so much. Amen. His name. I can't get over it. It's right there. So, I'm going to bring you some more good stuff, too. There's a lot of stuff in here we can talk about and get on the right track and do better for ourselves as Christians. Because remember, the Bible says a wise man, a wise man will leave an inheritance to his children. And you will think it's money if you want. Leave them a legacy of the Word of God. Leave them some substance so they can feed the sheep generations on down the line, okay? Y'all want to be the richest people in the world. And yes, it'll be left for other people. But let me tell you something. If you got your money wickedly, the wealth of the wicked is laid up for who? The just. So you can take that to your bed tonight. Have a good night. God bless you. And thank you so much. Oh, I love you all. Thank you all for fellowshipping. And yes, we're going to get through this. That's all I said. We're not going to die here today. Nobody going to bury us. This is what I'm saying. It's not wrong. If they take the time out, they busy life and stop deceiving people, they'll see who's really right. And I do believe it's Yahweh, Yeshua, Emmanuel, and the Holy Spirit, okay? And Jesus don't have nothing to do with the way people were walking with God before they got oppressed by all of the other outsiders. Partly because of your disobedience, and then partly because people just was against God's people and wanted to oppress them. So, good night. God bless you. It was really, really, really nice. I had a great time. I just want you guys to know his name is Emmanuel. Yes. So you can debunk that Jesus name, not the person per se. Find out who Christ is. Find out who Emmanuel is. Find out what the Bible says about it all. Okay? And go from there. Good night. Thank you. How do I put a thumbs up? Thumbs up, thumbs up. I can't do a thumbs up, y'all. I told y'all, I'm getting better. At least I can see your comments now and respond with you that way. But I would love to know how to just do a damn thumbs up. But anyway, good night. God bless you and have a great day.